Hello, good evening.
Hi, teacher.
Nubia. How are you?
Fine. And you, teacher?
Fine too. Here, just like trying to start a new week. Not actually
Sí.
week. Not actually week. Weekend, by the way. Yeah, I do really want this week to finish. That's why I'm saying that. I don't know you, but I do really want this week to finish.
Yes, I finished this week.
Yeah, and how was your day today? I'm sorry, I have the camera off because I'm changing the camera. Give me a second.
Okay, teacher.
Yes, and how was your week? Tell me, I mean, your day today, how was it?
Good.
Good.
I stayed at home. Yes.
Ah, really?
Sí.
You didn't go to work?
No, I don't work today.
Ah, that's great. That's why you look. That's why you have that smiling in your face, huh? Ooh, interesting.
Happy, very happy.
Very happy. Esa cara yo la única vez que la pongo es los domingos, porque estoy en casita.
Ah, okay.
Yeah. Ya, a mí no aplica así como Jonathan dice, es viernes y el cuerpo lo sabe y se emociona. Nah, I had to work on Saturdays. De hecho, el sábado es como mi día más pesado, like, because I work the whole day from 8 to 5, so that's why. But it's pretty cool when you have the vocation and you love what you do. You don't feel the time. You don't really feel the time. Yes. And you know, like I do really love teaching. That's like one of
I know.
my
I
favorite.
see.
Huh?
I see you.
Yes, I mean I do
I
really love
know that
teaching. Yes.
profession.
Yes, I mean it's like it's good. I love that. And I love teaching in every stage, like every age. I have groups of children. I have groups of adults like you, all of adults. I have been with teenagers, like every age. Yeah, I do really like teaching all kinds of people. All right, just give me a second.
Okay.
Yes, so that's why we are here, right? That's why I'm with that I don't know, like motivation to teach you what a little bit about what I know. And you know, like it's a sacrifice for you too, because you are here. Like despite you have a long day, you had a long day, a hard day sometimes. But we are here, that's the good way.
Teacher, you work at the children?
Yeah, I work with children.
Kids?
Yes, sometimes I have to work.
Wow.
Yes. And teaching English to kids is not that easy. Real, that easy. Yeah.
More in this time, the children, the kids muy, muy acelerados, muy hyper.
Yes. Nowadays, there are kids that makes me think that it was not a good idea to have a baby right now, but luego se me pasa. Yes.
Okay.
Nah, okay. All right, people. Okay, people, so we're gonna start with the things that we got for today. So please turn on your cameras. I want to see you. Okay, and I'm gonna start with the attendance list. So let's see, Ana Claribel, she usually connects late, right? Ana Maria, no there. Rosy is sleeping already. Diana Gabriela. Hey, Rosa. Qué cómoda está Rosa.
Ay, teacher, acá que... Es como me puse la vacuna, ya me está dando frío.
Oh, really? Today?
Y dolor de cabeza.
¿Tu primera dosis?
No, la segunda, pero más leve. Ay, no, porque con la primera todo el día pasó durmiendo, teacher. Todo el día. Parecía que no había dormido en unos 2 días.
Nah, my God. Ya me imagino. Ah. Sorry, Rosan. Okay. All right, Eric Guillermo. Ah, Eric is there. All right, good.
Present, teacher.
Okay, Eric. Ever de Jesús.
Present, teacher. Right. Me pareció haber visto ahí a Francisco Flores antes de mí, pero bueno.
Francisco Flores. ¿Cómo así?
Francisco Flores. Ey, no, hombre, tan ofensivo. Ey, hijo de puya.
Buenas noches, señor diputado.
Hey, Ever.
Hello.
Isn't that Calderón Sol? Because it's white.
Hey, no, ya ahorita me desconecto. Eso, yo sí no lo... ¿Sabe? No, ya, eso ya es demasiado.
Así no, ¿verdad, Eric?
Así no juego.
Okay, sorry, Eric.
Ahí le mandé un mensaje en WhatsApp, dicho.
Ah, okay, mister. Okay,
uh-huh. I will check.
Okay. Fátima Alejandra. No, you're right. Okay. Floridalia. Lord, no here. Okay. Hilmar Cruz.
Present.
Okay, good, Hilmar. Jonathan Alexander.
Present.
All right. Jonathan. Carla Benazir.
Present, teacher.
Okay, good. Natalie Vanessa. No there. Nubia Zulema.
Present, teacher.
Okay, good. Romeo Alexis.
Present, teacher.
Good. Rosa del Carmen.
Present.
Okay. Roxana Yesenia. All right, no, they are right. Salvador Alfonso. Okay. Good. Sara Carolina.
No creo, teacher, que Salvador se conecte porque cuando yo salí todavía quedaba en reunión.
Entonces, quién sabe entonces. Yeah, he's not gonna connect then. No se va a conectar entonces.
Sí, no creo, o un poco más tarde, pero sí dudo bastante porque yo salí de reunión y él iba entrando.
No, entonces no. Dudo mucho entonces. Thank you for the information, Eric. All right. Stephanie Lisette. No, here, right. Okay. William Alberto. No, here. Joanny Noemi. Okay, neither Joanny is here. And Stephanie.
Teacher, aquí estoy yo, present.
Ah, okay, Diana. Okay. Ya le había puesto en asistencia, mire. Okay, all right, good. So just let me share the presentation that we're gonna have for today. A second, how did I do this? No, okay, got it here. So I'm gonna share the presentation that we're gonna start off today. And this is the presentation. Let me know if you see the presentation. Can you see it? Can you see the presentation, people?
Yes.
No, okay, perfect. Okay, So this is the video conference number 12. 8 more video conferences and we finish this module. Today's topic is going to be how to use should and should not. All right. Yesterday's topic was like really interesting. It was part of the line of this type of modal verbs. Should is also a modal verb, okay? It's an auxiliary verb, okay? ¿Por qué es un verbo auxiliar? Porque no puede ser escrito en una oración sin la ayuda de otro verbo principal. Por sí solo no tiene relevancia. Like, to put it that way, okay? Siempre va a necesitar de otro verbo. So, entonces ahora vamos a ver un uso de should, all right? In the work context, of course. So that's what we are going to be talking throughout this video conference. So let's remember, every time you have doubts, you got a question, please just let me know, okay? Let me know. And please, if you are not eating, if you are like just sitting in your chair, try to turn on your cameras, okay? There you go, let's continue. Okay, the main things that we're going to have for the class, for the whole class. The first thing that we're going to be doing, as in every class, is that we're going to have a review from the previous class. Vamos a comenzar con un pequeño repaso del tema principal que estuvimos discutiendo ayer, okay? Like yesterday's class. All right, and then we're going to continue with the uses of should and should not, and then we're going to have a conversation, and at the end, some exercises in the book or in the manual, as you want to call them, okay? But this is the first thing that we're going to have for tonight, a review. Okay, let's start with that. What was the main topic from yesterday, people? Can you please tell me what was the topic from yesterday?
Goal and work.
Ah, okay, very good. It was cool and it was could you and what was the second one?
Would
you mind? Actually,
would you mind?
Yes, would you mind? Okay, very good. In this case, when or in what or for what do we use that structure or those structures? When do I have to use would you mind and could you? In what moment? What is the use of that? What is the use of that?
Petición formal.
Ah, okay. A formal request about something. Now, okay, very good. All right, let's just start talking a little bit about grammar, okay? Ever, could you please tell me what is the structure of could you? What is the structure? Grammatically speaking, what is the structure that we need to talk about could in questions?
In question, okay, yeah. Whatever question, the yeah. Structure mm-hmm. basically is could you mm-hmm. plus
okay, let me write it down. Aquí, let me write it down, please. Give me a second.
Okay.
Okay, let's put it this way here. Okay.
Okay.
Structure. Tell me.
The first is could you.
Okay, could you
plus base in form base
form of the verb
plus complement.
Ah, okay, very good. Ah, there is missing one plus question form, okay, because it's a question. All right, very good. Now any volunteer? Let's see. Jonathan, give me an example question following the structure. I want one example using this structure, Jonathan. Jonathan, you got your microphone off. And you were talking and you were mute. Okay. Okay, give me an example question using cool.
Could you make the dinner?
All right. Could you make the dinner? Okay, good. All right, perfect, Jonathan. Thank you. Give me a second. Give me a second. The D was missing. Thank you. Could you make the dinner? All right, thank you, Jonathan. Romeo, give me the answer to this question. Any answer. Recordemos que la respuesta puede ser corta, okay? Very short, but precise. Give me an example answer, Romeo. Could you make the dinner? Give me an answer. Romeo, ¿está hablando y está en mute? ¿O what happened?
No sé si me escucha ahora.
Yes, now I can listen to you.
Okay. ¿Cómo sería? ¿Could you make the No sé cómo sería la pregunta, teacher.
Ok, ¿podría hacer la cena o preparar la cena? Ok, en ese caso, algo corto quiero de respuesta. Como estuvimos practicando ayer. You remember?
Ok. ¿Cómo sería? Yes.
Yes, ajá.
Yeah, could you make?
No, Romeo, es que no me va a hacer una oración. Simplemente algo cortito a modo de respuesta afirmativa. Something short.
Sí, es que como ayer no estuve.
¿Ah? Really? Ayer no estuve. ¿Were you in class yesterday? Okay, Romeo, okay, no problem, Romeo. No problem. I forgot that you were not there. Okay, Carla, help Romeo, please. Give an answer.
In a minute.
Okay, in a minute. Okay, another way to answer this question, Carla, besides in a minute.
Okay, could you prepare the new meeting?
No. Oh, okay, that's a question. Could you prepare?
Yes, the new meeting.
Okay, thank you, Carla. All right, that was another example. Let's see who can help me out with the answer. Nubia, help me out providing an answer to this question.
Yes, of course.
Yes, of course. Thank you, Nubia. Hey, yes, of course. Okay, nice. Now, I want a third person example. Let's see if we remember. Even though we didn't use it because we used only first person. But let's see if you remember it. Hilmar, help me out, please. In third person.
En tercera persona.
Aha, even though we didn't practice, but I told you how to do it.
Yeah, would you close the door?
That's first person, Hilmar.
Tercera persona.
Just eliminate you and put a third person.
Could he close the door?
Nah, okay, very good. Could he close the door? Okay, and that's a correct question. What is the only difference? Okay, the only difference is that when we use this type of structures, okay, we are not sure about what the other person might answer, okay? La estructura igual está correcta y todo, solo que ese tipo de estructura, recordemos, es poco usable, por así decirlo. ¿Por qué? Porque generalmente no sabemos si la tercera persona a lo que nos estamos refiriendo estará ahí. Thank you, Hilmar. Estaba correcta.
¿Cómo sería la respuesta en el caso?
Sería lo mismo.
Sería lo mismo.
Yes.
¿Cómo podría asegurar el nombre de él? Porque estoy preguntando.
Exactly. En ese caso, básicamente la persona, a la persona que va dirigida la pregunta, o a la persona que usted le hace la pregunta, es la que tiene que contestar en lugar de la persona que usted se está refiriendo. Por eso es que le digo que es un poco común. Por ejemplo, put that into context. Supongamos que usted le hace esa pregunta a Romeo sobre Nubia. Could she open the door? Ah, Romeo le va a contestar. Yes, of course. Ok, en lugar de Nubia. Ok.
El nombre de ella.
Exactly. On her behalf. Entonces, por eso es que le menciono que es poco común usarlo. Pero la estructura es bueno poderla practicar o ponerla en contexto. Ok. Por lo menos el saber cómo se escribe o cómo se hace una pregunta en tercera persona de ese aspecto. ¿Ok?
Very good. Thank you.
Very good. Ok, let's continue. That was the first structure. Could you? What was the second structure? Because this was, let me see, could you? That was the one. Now, what was the second structure that we were practicing yesterday? Diana, are you there? Diana, are you there? Diana a la una, Diana a las dos, Diana no está ahí. Okay, good. Ever, what was the second structure that we were practicing yesterday?
Okay, teacher, the second structure is with the would you mind?
Ah, okay, thank you, Ever. Would you mind? There you go. Would you mind? And for this, I want Eric to give me the structure. What is the structure to make questions using would you mind, Eric?
Would you mind?
Uh-huh.
Plus a bear. ING.
Huh? What is that? ING. Ah, okay, okay. Now what? I'm interested.
Bear in ING.
In okay.
Plus compliment.
Give me a second. In ING. Plus complement. Ah. Okay. Plus.
Plus complement.
Aha. Uh-huh. Plus complement. Plus.
Question.
Yeah.
Question. Thank you.
Question mark. Okay, that was the one. There you go. Very good. Now, who else is connected? Sarah was not here yesterday, so I cannot ask Sarah. I cannot ask Romeo. Salvados por la campana. Okay, let's see who can help me out with this. Rosa, are you there, Rosa? Didn't you sleep yet? Okay, creí que ya había perdido la batalla, Rosa. She was asleep.
Almost.
Okay, Rosa. No, no.
Cortando margaritas.
Cortando margaritas. No, Rosa. Can you please give me an example question using would you mind? I want one example, Rosa. of a question using would you mind?
Would you mind preparing the dinner?
Would you mind
preparing the dinner?
Now, okay, thank you, Rosa. Nice. Would you mind preparing the dinner? So we got the structure here. Would you mind? After the structure, we got the verb in ing. Okay, and the dinner is just a complement, right? It's just a complement to make the question more specific, okay? That's why we use it. Just to make the question more specific. There you go. And Jonathan, give an answer to this question.
Yes, of course.
Ah, okay, thank you, Jonathan. Yes, of course. Yes, in a minute, right away, right? Those are the forms how we can use it, okay? How we can use it. What happened? Ah, there you go. Right away. So those are like the ways how we can do with these, okay, type of questions, right? So this was part of the feedback that we got from yesterday, right? So we were like discussing that structure. So let's see. I don't know, by the place where you live, people, is it raining right now? Is it raining there? Nope, nah, okay. Because here it's like raining hard. It's raining hard, that's weird.
En San Miguel porque son muy pecadores, por eso llueve mucho.
No, hombre, si aquí no sobra agua por doquier. Pecadores, dice Eric. Ya, yeah. Pescadores quiso decir, ¿verdad? Ya, yeah. Mucha pesca por acá. Okay, let's continue. So this was part of the feedback that we have from yesterday, okay? Just to bring up how we create questions using could you and would you mind. I don't know if you copied this information. No sé si le tomaron captura o copiaron esta información. You did it? Okay.
Finish.
Perfect. Let's continue then. Give me a second. There you go. So now we're going to start up with the use of should and should not, which is the structure that we're going to be practicing today. After that, we're going to have a short conversation practice, okay, using should. And then we're going to have some exercises in the manual, okay? We're gonna work in the manual and a couple of minutes at the end, and that's pretty much what we got, okay? That's pretty much what we got. So, but before I continue with the topic, let's start with this. Regulations in your company. Let's start some discussions to... Hi, Roxana. Enjoy it, Roxana. Buen provecho.
Gracias.
Con todo, man. That's good, Roxana. Yeah, man. Ya me va a dar hambre a mí también. Ya vamos a dejar la clase, vamos a ir a comer. No. Okay, let's continue. Let's start up discussing this couple of questions that are in your manual. Vamos a comenzar con un par de preguntitas de discusión, okay, que están en su manual también, all right? You can find them in the manual, specifically on page 29, I think, if I'm not wrong. This is the first question. So, Hilmer, help me on reading this question, please.
Does your company have regulation about employees' behavior?
Okay. Does your company have regulations about your employees' behavior? Okay. In your case, Hilmer, in your company, are there these type of regulations?
Yes.
Okay. Ah, there you go. Do they follow up this type of regulations? By do they follow up, I'm talking about siguen las indicaciones, siguen este tipo de regulaciones, or it's just simple to just for be there. Siguen al pie de la letra este tipo de regulaciones sobre conductas en your company?
Yes, usually.
Ah, okay, because behavior means, you know, like it talks about how you act in your work. Básicamente, like behavior regulations or employees' behavior is like la forma en cómo usted actúa en su trabajo, cómo interactúa con los demás en su trabajo, ¿ok? Si usted se porta bien, si usted no se porta tan bien, y si no se porta bien, ¿qué tipo de regulaciones son las que existen en el lugar de trabajo? ¿Ok? That's what it means. So, are there regulations in the place where you work, Hilmar?
¿Cuáles son las regulaciones, dice, no?
Ah, sí hay regulaciones para un tipo de conducta que no sea tan positivo. Yes or no?
Ask them y cumplir, ¿cómo sería?
Ah, for example, let's imagine, right, just let's imagine that Rosa is in the work y el jefe encuentra a Rosa sí, like dormidita Rosa. Okay, do you think is there a regulation for that?
Sí, tengo horario de trabajo.
Ajá, yes.
Hay pauta, ¿verdad? Entonces, en ese momento sí pueden hacerlo.
Okay, very good. All right, thank you, Hilmar. Choose one of your classmates.
Yo casi siempre.
Okay, all right, perfect. Now, choose one of your classmates, Hilmar, to participate. Choose one of your classmates.
Compañero.
Yes, choose one.
Al colega Eric.
I don't know why, but I knew that you were about to choose Eric.
Yo por el otro modo lo voy a pedir cambio. De grupo. Esto ya no puede ser así.
All of them tells you. Choose you. Okay. Eddie, are there regulations in the place where you work for employees' behavior?
Yes, teacher.
Ah, okay. Good.
For example, el horario, work
schedule?
Work schedule? Por schedule.
Okay.
Basic.
No, okay, but you have to follow up, right? That is schedule.
Yes.
Oh, okay. Very good. There you go. Good. Ever, how about the place where you live? I mean, you live. You work. Is there any regulation for any type of behavior that you might have?
Yes, we have to. For example, like Eric, the schedule.
It means if you don't get on time to your work, they tell you something.
How to say the septimo? This is one regulation or one penalty about this.
En séptimo, what is that about?
They am seventh, día y séptimo, cuando le descuentan el día y séptimo, ese sería un ejemplo.
Yes, hey, that's true. Eso duele. That hurts. That hurts, that's true.
Sí, cuando excede de un tiempo determinado, por ejemplo, for example, you have 30 minutes for a week. When you pass this time, nos descuentan esa cantidad.
Oh.
Yeah, it's hard.
Like very difficult. Just imagine if you are going driving to your work, and there is an accident on your road, and you cannot move on. So just because of that, just because you get late, you receive that penalty. Or there is a justification for that.
When we have a justification for about this, this is la excepción de la regla, the rule exception, no?
No, okay.
That is justificated, no problem. Mm-hmm. With some files or when you have an emerging de salud, ¿cómo se dice? How do you say salud?
Health emergency.
The health where your family, something like that. But if you don't justificate it,
if you don't justify, then you're like, okay, all right, that's interesting. Okay, there you go. So most of the companies, they got their own rules, right? They are regulations. Okay, now name three examples of unacceptable behavior in your company. What are those behaviors that in your company are not accepted? What are they? Example, in your company, if you get drunk, if you drink alcohol, beers, and everything, and you get to work like almost sleeping and everything.
Why not?
Why not? You can do, if you don't work tomorrow, you can do that today. I mean, tonight. No problem, right? No problem. But is there a justification? Or it is like enough proof for you to get fired? Or receive a penalty? Let's start up with Jonathan. Jonathan, can you please mention three examples of unacceptable behavior in your company? ¿Podría mencionarme tres ejemplos de conductas no aceptables en su compañía o lugar de trabajo? What are they?
Here or there. ¿Cómo se dice? Ahí no se aceptan peleas. Ahí no se aceptan peleas.
Ah, you don't have to fight.
Perdón.
You don't have to fight.
You don't have to fight.
Ajá. Any fight.
Okay.
What else?
We don't run in the company.
Nah, okay. All right. You don't have to run? No, okay. And the last one? Give me another one.
We don't buy other motorcycle.
Okay. So it is okay. So by buying another motorcycle significa de que O sea, if you work in Yamaha, no significa que hubiera comprado una serpiente. o comprar otra ahí. Okay. I understood that, Jonathan. All right, thank you. Now, Carla, in your case, what can be an acceptable behavior in your company?
For example, later arrivals.
Now, okay,
not unfamily company in the work.
Ah, okay. You cannot have any other family in the same work.
Yeah.
So if you have a sister and she wants to work in that place, she cannot work.
No work, teacher.
Ah, okay. All right. Good. All right. Thank you, Carla. Okay. Give another one.
The meal times.
Nah, okay. All right. There you go. Thank you, Carla. Okay, Eric. What are like the unacceptable behavior that in your company must not be accepted?
Okay. The store. Fight.
Any fight?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Presenting in a drunk state.
Okay, all right. So none of them are acceptable. Okay. Let's see another participation. William, how about your company, William? What are those behaviors that are not acceptable for employees?
They use the phone.
Okay, the use of the phone. Okay.
I said the brevity.
Okay.
Soborno.
Yeah, Brian.
Don't wear uniform complete.
So you wear a uniform in your work?
Yes.
So if you don't have the complete uniform, there is a penalty for you?
Yes.
Okay, that's interesting. Okay, William, thank you. Mrs. Urrutia, in your case, in your company, you work with Natalie, right? Okay, between you both, ¿podrían mencionarme las dos cuáles son esas conductas negativas que no son aceptables en su compañía? What are those negative behaviors that are not acceptable in the place where you work?
Me da miedo quedarme completamente muda.
Conductas.
Yes. Esas regulaciones. You don't have to do them or are not acceptable.
Don't use the cell phone. Como faltas injustificadas también.
Like when you don't go to work and you don't say why. Don't go.
De puntualidad, ¿cómo es? Ser puntuales. ¿Puntuality? A la hora.
Punctuality. Okay. It means that you have to be on time.
Yes.
Okay.
Stall también, teacher. Robo, no sé si así se pronuncia.
Still.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, you cannot steal to your company or to your employees, to your coworkers. Ahí así como que, Mrs. Urrutia tiene 10 pesos acá, saquémoselo.
también they use the sandals.
You cannot use sandals?
No.
Ah, okay. Yeah. All right, those are regulations, right? In the place where yes. you work. Okay, so thank you, Mrs. Urrutia and Natalie. Fatima, I'm gonna end up with you, Fatima. What are those regulations that are in your company that you have to follow? And the regulations that are not acceptable for you?
No cumplir con horario, con el horario.
No, okay. Not to accomplish the schedule, okay.
El uso del use the cell phone también.
Ah, okay, the cell phone use.
Y,
yeah, I mean, in your work, you're not gonna be like sharing memes on Facebook or posting things, right? Ah, okay.
Y el uso del uniforme, pero hasta ciertos días, en cierta semana. No. En la semana. Hay ciertos días para cumplir.
Ah, okay. Very good. All right. Thank you, Fatima. Okay. So basically, that's a little bit of a talk. Okay. About the regulations that we got in our company. Poco a poco vamos a ir haciendo esas pequeñas como preguntas de discusión en las cuales ustedes me proveen de información, okay? In English. All right, let's continue up with this. Now, let's jump into the topic. Sure. This is the main topic that we got for tonight, all right? When to use sure. And how to use it. Let's see, I want the participation of somebody that has not participated in the class. Ana Garcia, read this for me, please.
Should is used to make suggestion, creo que es.
To make suggestions.
To make?
Suggestions.
Suggestion and heal.
Give
advice.
And give advice.
Advice.
Ah, okay, very good. Should is used to make suggestions and give advice. Esos dos son los usos principales que tenemos de este modal verb. Okay, should. ¿Para qué es usado? Para hacer sugerencias y dar qué. Dar consejo, ok? Proveer consejo about something. We got some examples, as always. So let's see. Natalie, read this example, please.
You should call your family.
Okay, you should call your family. There you go. What are we doing there? Ah, ¿qué estamos haciendo ahí? ¿Qué estamos dando a denotar con esa oración? Ah, estamos dando un consejo o una sugerencia de qué hay que hacer. Should tiene traducción, a pesar de ser un verbo auxiliar, it has a translation, ¿ok? Y significa deberías, ¿ok? Ese es el significado de should dentro de una oración, ¿ok? Es uno de los modal verbs que tiene traducción. ¿Y sería? Debería. Okay, that is the translation. So in the example here, we got you should call your family. Ah, deberías llamar a tu familia. What am I giving there? Ah, estoy dando una sugerencia. Okay, a suggestion about what to do. Romeo, read the second example, please.
I should work every day.
Ah, okay. I should work every day. If you want to make money, you should work every day, right? So, what does it mean? Debería trabajar todos los días, right? What a good advice. Okay, another one. Let's see. In my case, I want a new computer, so I had to work every day. Ever, read this example, please.
Okay, Mario should go to the meeting.
Okay, Mario should go to the meeting. What does it mean in there? Ah, is providing a suggestion. Ahí estamos dando una sugerencia, ok, a alguien de hacer algo. Ok, remember that. Algo peculiar pasa con este tipo de auxiliares, verbos modales auxiliares. ¿Qué sucede con ellos? En tercera persona, si ustedes ven ahí, no sufre ninguna modificación. There is no any modification in there. ¿Qué significa eso? Significa que podemos usar la tercera persona y el su no se le va a agregar S, ES, ni mucho menos IES. ¿Ok? It remains the same. Permanece intacto, permanece lo mismo. Just keep that on mind, ¿ok? En este caso, sí no nos tenemos que preocupar por el uso de la S, ES o IES. ¿Ok? Because it's not used. All right. Good. Vamos a ver ahora un poco de estructura. The structure. Okay, of should. What is the structure of this modal? This is the structure. You see? Nuria, read the structure, please.
Yes, teacher. Subject plus should plus base form of verb plus complement.
Okay, thank you, Nuria. So basically, that's the structure that we have to follow up, okay, in order to create examples using this model, okay? We got an example, of course. Roxana, can you please read this example?
You shall go
okay. Home. All right, all right. Okay, let's repeat again. You should repeat. Roxana? Hello? Roxana? Okay. I think the internet is gone for Roxana. Okay, pero amablemente Natalie le va a ayudar.
You should go home after work.
Okay, thank you, Natalie. Thank you. Okay. You should go home after work. So you is basically the subject. Should is the structure that we got there. Go is the base form of the verb. Ahí ya tenemos el verbo en forma base, que en este caso sería el verbo go. Home after work ya sería el complemento. Okay? To make the sentence more specific. Okay, good. Let's continue. Carla. Tell me I'm reading this one.
Sí, le dan mucha venita, va, teacher.
Obviously. No, pues sí, mi querida esposa me cuida, ya ve.
Está bien.
Yes, of course. All right, Carla.
Okay.
Look at Eric. Hey, Eric, no sea así. Okay, Carla, continue.
Okay, she should greet her clients.
Now, okay. She should, okay, greet her clients.
Okay. She should greet her clients.
Okay, thank you. She should greet her clients. Okay, what is greet? Do you know what is that? Greet?
Saludo.
Exactly. But that is the verb. Saludar. Okay. She should greet her clients. Ella debería saludar a sus clientes, right? That is a suggestion, okay, that we are providing. En todos esos ejemplos, ¿qué estamos haciendo? Dando una sugerencia o consejo sobre algo, okay? About something. That's what we got there. All right, let's read another example. Let's see, someone has not that has not participated already. Romeo. Romeo wants to participate.
They should buy a car.
Okay. They should buy a car. There you go. That is a suggestion, right? Especially when people live very far from the place where they work, it is advisable to buy a car. Okay, good. Right up to here, people. Do we have any questions related to this? ¿Tenemos alguna duda con relación a cómo utilizar el should? ¿In what moments to use it? Any question? ¿Alguna duda? ¿O todo está claro? ¿Everything is clear?
Teacher.
Yes.
Que the meeting, or reach repeat, please.
The meeting.
The meeting, yeah. The for in the second sentence. I can hear the meaning for this word, the reach.
In what example, Ever?
The second example, teacher. She
should greet her clients. Greet.
Greet, yes. What's the meaning for this
meaning,
word? Greet.
Saludar. Saludar.
Saludar.
Yes. Okay. Yes. All right. Yeah, it's just like saludar. Like when you say hi, good morning, good afternoon, good night, good evening, whatever, right? That is like to greet. Like saludar. There you go. Any other question? ¿Estamos bien hasta acá? Okay. If we are okay with here. William, tell me.
En anterior presentación, había una oración que decía Mario should go to the meeting.
This one? Mario should go to the meeting. What happened in there, William?
Meeting is in ING.
In that case, meeting significa reunión. Meeting.
Meet
es reunir. En este caso es, digamos que depende del contexto en el que lo utilicemos, William, así va a ser el tipo de traducción que tiene. Example, ¿ha escuchado usted la expresión nice to meet you? So yes. Ahí es like from conocer, right? That's one of the ways that we got, right? And then, okay, we got meet from reunir, okay? To get together, all right? Yeah. So those are like the two translations that we got for that one. Entonces, una es reunir y la otra es conocer. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, so we got two translations for that specific word. Entonces tenemos dos traducciones para ese tipo de, okay, de expresiones. Parece específicamente del meet.
Okay.
Yes, y así como meeting, así como está ahí, y ahí es reunión. ¿Por qué? Porque ahí ya no es verbo, sino que está actuando como un nombre dentro de una oración.
Okay. Yes.
Yeah, porque ahí el verbo principal, el verbo sería el go. Go. There you go.
Let's okay, continue. Thank you.
Okay. No problem, mister. Okay, good. All right, what are we going to do right now with this? Now, I want you to give me an example. Quiero que me hagan un ejemplo en primera y un ejemplo en tercera persona, okay? Utilizando una sugerencia. Giving a suggestion for someone or for something to do something. Example. Supongamos yo diga, I am sick. Yo les digo, hey, I am sick. ¿Qué me sugerirían ustedes? ¿Cuál sería la sugerencia? Cualquiera me puede decir. If you are sick, listen up. You should go to the doctor. You should go to the doctor. right? That is a suggestion, okay? Algo ahí como para ayudar a reforzar el tema, okay? If I am sick, I should go to the doctor, right? That's a suggestion. All right, let's do one by yourself. Let me know when you finish. Two examples, one in first person and the second one in third person. All right, in the meantime, mientras ustedes hacen los ejemplos, voy a pasar asistencia, okay? The second attendance list. Give me a second. Voy a dejar de compartir un momento. La amo, vieja pensión. Okay, let's see. Ana Claribel.
Present.
Yeah, okay, good. Ana María.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Diana Gabriela. Diana. Hey, Diana, it's not connected. Okay. Juraba que estaba conectada. Eric Guillermo.
Present, teacher.
All right. Ever de Jesús.
Present, teacher.
Okay, very good. Fátima Alejandra.
Present, teacher.
Okay, perfect. Floridalia is not here. Gilmar Cruz.
Present.
Okay, very good. Jonathan Alexander.
Present.
Okay, thank you. Carla Benazir.
Present.
All right, perfect. Natalie Vanessa.
Present.
Okay. Nubia Zulema.
Present, teacher.
Good. Romeo Alexis.
Present.
All right, Rosa del Carmen. Rosa, are you there? Okay, I think, creo que perdimos a Rosa. Roxana Yesenia. Hey, Roxana was there. Where is Roxana? I didn't have her. Salvador Alfonso.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you, Salvador. Sara Carolina.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Stephanie Lisette.
Present.
Okay, very good. William Alberto. William. Ah, okay, William. Joanny Noemi. Hey, Joanny is not here. Hmm. That's good. And Stephanie Janet. Hey, he's a teacher. Hey, Stephanie is not here. Hmm. That's good. Okay.
Teacher.
Hello. Ah. Okay, Rosa. Now it's here. Vamos a ver dónde está. Ya le había puesto en asistencia, Rosa. No, she's dying, Rosa. Okay, people, do you finish the exercise? I mean, the exercise, the examples?
Yes.
That was easy. Okay, let's start out with you, Hilmar. Read them, please.
In the parts,
I should drink a lot of water.
Ah, okay, very good.
And second, in third person, she should drive carefully.
Okay, she should drive carefully. Yeah, I mean, talking about, no me lo van a tomar a mal, pero en serio, qué mal manejan algunas señoras. For real. Ahora, en serio, ahora que venía de camino a casa, por poco y no les doy la clase. For real, I was about to have an accident with a lady. Una señora venía por la principal y simplemente se metió y ya, sí, como
teacher.
Lo que sucede es, no es hablar mal, pero ellas tratan de hacer varias cosas al mismo tiempo, de hecho es una habilidad, solo que en la conducción es más peligroso.
Pero, en la mayoría de clases de manejo,
el encienda que le enseña su cámara.
A una mujer es un hombre, así que los hombres son los que enseñan mal.
Ana María.
Dígame, teacher. Mire.
Okay, Ana María. Listen. Si a mí
piensen lo que me va a responder.
Nah.
Voy a hablar yo mejor para que no me peleen. Activó el avispero, teacher.
Yes. No, Ana María es la que está enojada. Ay. No, Ana María. No. Listen, solo le voy a decir a Ana María. Si el instructor a mí me dice, pase ese semáforo en rojo, no hay que hacerlo.
Obviamente.
No, es que mire, fíjense que me dio cólera porque venía por la principal y de un solo se me atravesó la señora, así como que, apártese o lo aparto. Y yo estoy. Y no, o sea.
No, teacher.
Yo por eso dije, no everybody, no todas.
Y comienza a decirle cosas en inglés como no entendía.
¿Y usted qué hizo, teacher? ¿Le tuvo miedo o se mantuvo?
Respiré profundo y dije.
Le dio su respectiva.
No, tampoco.
Este, o así como hay hombres que insultan a las mujeres cuando van manejando.
Nah, I was too tired. You know what? De hecho, ya me ha chocado una señora. Cuando andaba en moto, me pegó una señora y me tiró de la moto, literal. Y she paid me, right? Me pagó el daño, pero...
Pero yo comparto con usted y eso es cierto. La mayoría de mujeres manejan mal. Yo hasta me he discutido y porque a la brava me han querido sacar del carril, más las que andan manejando camioneta, pero manejan de la patada.
You know what? Yes. I am not against of that. And I say it's good that women drive. Hay unas señoras, en serio, o sea, no todas, not everybody, because there are exceptions, okay? I know women that are perfect drivers, but there are some of them that, not that much. Yes, yo siempre encuentro a alguien cuando voy de camino al trabajo, que en el carril que se debe de sobrepasar, se va maquillando. That's funny to see that, really funny.
Teacher, yes. me voy a ausentar un ratito. Es que ahorita acabo de llegar del hospital. Me caí, teacher, y tengo un esguince en el pie, sí. Me tengo en la cara también, en la rodilla. Me hicieron varias radiografías por la migraña, quizás andaba muy mareada. Entonces hoy en la mañana me caí.
Okay.
Entonces ahorita tengo que ir a cambiarme el hielo que tengo en el pie. Right, ya voy a regresar.
Temprano comenzó.
¿Qué dijo?
Go, Ana.
Agregarle hielo a la bebida. ¿Cómo fue que dijo?
Ya le voy a enseñar mi pie. Okay, permita.
Okay. All right, let's continue. Carla, read your examples, please.
No hay respeto, man.
Okay, teacher.
Yeah.
I I should sleep more.
No, okay. I should sleep. Okay. Me too. Me too, definitely. Okay. Second example.
Yes. They should quit smoking.
They should quit smoking.
Quit smoking. Okay.
Very good, Carla. Thank you. William, can you please read your examples?
Okay. He should will jacket out the house.
No, okay.
You should write a song.
You should write a song. No, okay. Very good, okay. William. Thank you.
Okay.
Eric, read your examples.
Okay, teacher, you should buy a new shoes.
Yes.
She should study for the exam.
Now, okay, very good, Mary. Thank you. Fatima, for yours.
You should eat more vegetables.
Yes, I'm fine.
Andrea should buy new computer.
A new computer. Very good. Nubia, read your examples.
Sí, Sofía. Andrea should go to the university.
Did you get copy each other? Suspicious. Suspicious. Okay. Read the second example.
They show learns to English.
Okay, they should learn English. Very good. Yes, learn English. Okay. Very good, Nubia. Jonathan, read your examples.
You should study English.
Okay, very good.
She should work for family.
She should?
He should work for family.
For the family. Ah, okay. All right. Thank you, Jonathan. Sara.
Be sure go for the dream.
Okay, okay. Read again the example, please.
They should go for the dream.
Ah, they should go for a drink. Very good.
No sé si está bien esta. Como venía en el camino, casi la escuchaba.
Okay.
You should do the laundry.
You should do the laundry. Mm-hmm. Okay, very good. Yes. You should do the laundry. That's what my wife says every Sunday. And I was like, okay. Yeah, and I put the clothes in the you know, in the laundromat, and I do it. All right, good, Sarah. Mrs. Urrutia, hey, is it cold there, Mrs. Urrutia? I see you. You are like cold.
Sí, yo sí tengo mucho frío desde temprano. Está lloviendo.
Ah, ya le iba a decir, Mrs. Urrutia no se bañó. La veo con frío.
No es así, really? Como estoy en el patio.
Ah, that's good. Hey, that's good.
Es que si entro, los niños no me dejan en paz.
Okay. All right. Yeah, I mean, the weather is excellent by that place. Okay, read your examples.
She should save for her trip.
Nah, okay.
And I should connect to class at 8 p.m.
Yes, you should. Another one. I should turn on the camera during the whole class.
Yes.
Very good. Ay, mire. Nomás escuchó cámara y el Romeo Paz la conectó. Good. Romeo, yeah, turn on the camera. Okay, Ever, thank you, Mrs. Urrutia. Ever, read your examples.
Okay, the first, I should study
for the next test.
Okay, very good.
And the second, Maria should carry the umbrella.
Okay, perfect. Natalie?
I should do exercise. El otro sería, he should drink water.
Okay, very good. Romeo?
You should buy new a cell phone.
A new cell phone.
Okay.
A new cell phone.
You show out and family.
Repeat the example, please.
You show out de salir.
You should go,
and family.
You should go with your family. Okay, okay. With your family. Thank you, Romeo.
Okay.
That was the example, right?
She
should. You got another one. Okay, she should
eat pizza.
Okay, she should eat pizza. Hey, I was hungry today and I wanted to eat pizza, but my wife said no. You're on a diet. You cannot eat pizza. And I was like, okay. Yeah, man. She has me on a diet. Supposedly. Supposedly. Yeah. It's difficult for me to quit the bread. I love bread.
I mean, me too.
Yes. El pan dulce es lo peor. Mira, Eric. Pues. Eric, let's go on a diet, Eric. Nos tienen en dieta, Eric. Y nosotros rompiéndola.
No, mi hija menor hizo unas rayó papas, y las hizo tipo tortitas con queso.
Nah, hey, that's sexy.
Ay, es que aquí me trajo, ya me voy comiendo como 6.
Y la para la cerveza.
Nah, mentira. Soy saludable.
El six pack, Luis. Sí.
El agua de tu hija, hombre.
Ok.
No, lo que pasa es que le atrasó, Eric.
Hola. Hola.
Ahí le atrasó la morena en el envase.
Todas las técnicas que me dan, va.
Hay
capacitación.
Hay training, ok. All right. Okay, let's continue. Let's see who else is missing. Ana Garcia, read your examples.
She should exercise every day.
Okay, very good.
You should eat healthy.
Yes, I should. I should eat healthy, but I don't want. I love pizza. Okay, thank you, Anna. Who else is missing? Rosa, did you do them, Rosa?
Yes.
Okay, Rosa, go on.
Okay, sería, she should go slow.
Slow, okay, she should go slow.
Lo que debería estar haciendo, I should be sleeping.
Qué valor. No, I mean, wait. Let me see. 40 more minutes and you go to sleep. You see? In 40 minutes, you go to sleep, Rosa. No problem. Okay?
Okay.
She's crying. Okay. All right. Who else is missing? Who has not participated? Because I see some of you got the cameras off.
Yo, no quiero participar.
Okay, Roxana, go on.
Teacher, como se me desconecté, pero realicé dos preguntas.
Okay.
No sé si estarán bien estas oraciones. You should go park family.
You should.
You should go park family. She should music romantic.
She should es, vaya, después de should necesitamos un verbo. Vamos a ver. Vamos a ver. She should. Léame lo demás, por favor.
She should go park family.
Ah, ok. She should go to the park with the family. I'm gonna write it down in here. Look. She should go to the park with the family. Like that. I'm gonna send it to you in a message. She should go to the park with the family. Okay, what was the other one? ¿Cuál era la otra? ¿A Roxana?
Era she should music romantic, pero entonces me faltaría el verbo, ¿verdad? Mm-hmm. Después de should.
Ajá, you might say she should listen.
Like, de gustar. Ah, sería okay. She should like music romantic.
Romantic music.
Romantic music. Ajá.
No, okay. She should like romantic music. No, okay. Yes. Puro temerario. Nah, nah. That's when you're drinking Coca-Cola. like the good one. Okay. Let's continue. Because I think everybody has already participated. Yeah, I think. Okay, let's continue. Now, let's see the negative form. It says, should not, okay? Should not is also known as shouldn't, okay? Let's see, we didn't have that in here. No tenemos ejemplos con ellos acá, okay? But, hay una forma contractada de este auxiliar plus not. ¿Qué lo podemos hacer? Que sería más o menos así. Give me a second. Like this. Shouldn't.
Shouldn't.
Yeah. Should not or shouldn't. Listen up. Shouldn't. That is another way, okay, to put this into a negative. Aquí ya estaríamos contractando el should plus not. Ok, todos juntos en una sola. Shouldn't. Even though the examples like that are not with a contraction. They are separated. Ok, let's continue. Let's see who can help me out with this. Diana, are you there? Diana. All right, Diana, are you there?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, can you please help me on reading, Diana?
Show.
Should? Uh-huh.
Show not use to give a suggestion about.
Suggestion?
A suggestion about something that is not appropriate.
That is not appropriate, right?
Appropriate.
Okay, yes, that is not appropriate. Okay, in that case, we use should not. When do we use it? Ah, lo usamos el should not para dar una sugerencia sobre algo que no es apropiado, okay? That's what it means, okay? To give an advice or a suggestion about something that is not appropriate, okay? Very good, that is one way. All right, let's continue. We got an example, of course. Let's see, someone that has not participated that much. Salvador, read the example.
Maria should not use many emojis in his mail.
Okay. Dario should not use many emojis in his email, right? Just imagine if you are sending an email to one of your clients using emojis, that is not appropriate, okay? So that is a suggestion, right? Not to do it, okay? Especially you, Salvador. Imagine you talking or sending emails to the Chinese people using emojis. That will be not right.
El correo no.
Yeah. Hoy el correo no es como antes, right? Like one before, you remember? Los zumbidos. That was funny.
Nah, y menos mi trabajo.
Exactly. Okay. Let's keep going. Roxana, read this example, please.
Helen should not speak so loudly.
Loudly. Okay.
Loudly.
Thank you, Roxana. Helen should not speak so loudly. Okay. Very good. What it says? Ah, this is a suggestion, okay, of not doing that activity. Entonces acá estamos dando una sugerencia de que eso no se debe hacer. Okay. En este caso, Helen no debería hablar tan fuerte. Okay. Loudly significa fuerte, okay, cuando alzamos la voz. That's what it means. There you go. Let's continue. Who else has not participated that much? Natalie, help me out, please.
Gabriel should not tell sexist jokes.
No, okay, good. Like, as always, right? Siempre tenemos un amigo medio zafado y sale con algunas cosas medio inapropiadas en el trabajo, right? So, I mean, we can apply that in the job, okay? So we can apply that part. So, let's continue. I think these are like the only ones. But I got another one. Let's see who can help me out with this. Ana Maria. Let's do it, Ana Maria. Help me out, really.
Perdón. Es que ahorita mi enfoque está en otra parte. Y déjeme ver. Este es Noder.
Your boss?
No sé, teacher.
Ahorita. The last example. Just read.
Uh-huh. Ah, que lo lea.
Yes, Ana María.
Es que no le digo que mi mente está en otra parte. Tengo un gran hielo. Tengo hielo en mi pie. Your boss should not. Y la otra palabra, shoot at you.
Shout.
Shoot.
Shout.
Mm-hmm. At you. Mm-hmm. Yes. ¿Qué quiere decir esa otra palabra?
All right. Shout. What do you think is that? So that's something negative.
Mm-hmm.
What is shout?
No, después. Ajá, esa. Después dice, your boss shall not shoot. Esa.
Okay, it's like, for example, Ana Maria. Let's suppose I am your boss. And you say, Ana Maria, what did you do? Like, and I shot my boss.
Ah.
What is that?
Me está gritando.
There you go.
Y eso no se lo permito yo a nadie.
Really? Neither your boss?
No.
Ah, really?
Le digo... Un momento, bájale ahí tres rayitas.
Really? That's what you said to your boss?
En mi trabajo me dicen señora Ana. O sea, de mucho respeto.
Really?
Ya.
No por nada, le dicen señora Ana. Very English. Yeah, I mean, imagínense ahí a la señorita Ana ahí con sus lentes ahí bien enojada y like, what? Like looking up, everybody's like, hey. Not here, right? Not here. Okay. All right. Good. Do we have any questions related to this? No sé si tenemos alguna duda con relación a cómo, all right, dar sugerencias sobre algo negativo utilizando esta estructura negativa. ¿No?
Solo si puede repetir la forma contractada, porque ahí sin cómo se pronuncia.
Which one? La forma contractada.
Shouldn't.
That would be the separated one. Shouldn't, the contracted one. Shouldn't.
Yeah, shouldn't. Okay, thank you.
All right, very good. Okay, let's move on. Now, what do we got there? We're going to have a short conversation. Esta pequeña conversación ustedes la tienen en el manual. Okay, so let's go and watch it in the manual. Ahora, voy a dejar de compartir acá la pantalla y nos vamos a ir directamente al manual a leerla desde ahí, ¿ok? Give me a second. There you go. What? Ah, yeah. This is the conversation. Take this out. Okay, let's read the conversation, okay? Let's read it. This is the conversation between Claudia and Raul. And it says, Claudia, listen. I can't believe it.
Teacher.
Okay. ¿Quién tiene la novela?
Ah, quizá yo. No es la novela, se llama La Señora de Acero, que es de Netflix.
Ah, okay. All right, let's continue.
Es que para empezar, no, ahorita no me puedo mover a estar moviendo cosas, algo así. Perdón, no estaba en mute.
No problem. Okay. All right, it says, Claudia, I can't believe it. I can't believe it. Robert is addicted to his phone. Robert is addicted to his phone. Did you see him? Did you see him? It says, Raul. You're right. You're right. He should not chat. He should not chat in a meeting. In a meeting. And it says, Claudia, absolutely. Absolutely. That is not polite. That is not polite. It says, Raul, he should answer. He should answer his messages. His messages after the meeting. After the meetings. And we should not talk. And we should not talk about him. About him. That's not polite either. That's not polite either. Okay. And it says, Claudia, agree. Agree. Okay. We should help him instead. We should help him instead. Okay. All right, people, from here. Now, I'm going to read it, okay, sequentially, continuously. It says, I can't believe it. Robert is addicted to his phone. Did you see him? Dice Raúl, you're right. He should not chat in a meeting. Absolutely, says Claudia. That is not polite. And Raúl says, he should answer his messages after the meetings. And we should not talk about him. That's not polite either. And it says, Claudia, agree. We should help him instead. Okay, from here, do we have any questions related to this vocabulary?
Teacher,
yes.
Hater.
Either.
¿Cómo?
Either. This one?
Either.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Either.
Okay. ¿Cuándo utilizar either? Listen up. Generalmente, cuando nosotros tenemos una oración en positivo, look at that. Si yo digo, I am hungry, generalmente, si alguien más, uno de ustedes, tiene hambre, también me va a decir, me too. Es lo que generalmente decimos para decir, yo también, ¿cierto? Like, me too. Ok. Ahora bien, cuando una oración es negativa, cuando una oración es negativa, por ejemplo, si yo digo, I want to sleep, quiero dormir, ok, me dirían ustedes, me too. Pero si yo digo, I don't want to sleep, like, no quiero dormir. Y si ustedes también están de acuerdo en que no quieren dormir, no me van a decir me too. ¿Okay? Ustedes tienen la opción de decir me either o me neither. So el either en ese caso, ¿ok? Está afirmando de una manera negativa un suceso. ¿Ok? So that's not polite either significa eso tampoco es cortés. Entonces either es como tampoco. ¿Right? Did we get it? ¿Entendimos? Very good. Any other vocabulary word from there that you do not understand?
La última palabra, teacher.
Instead?
Uh-huh.
Okay, we should help him instead. Ah, esta todo es una sola frase. We should help him instead. Ah, deberíamos ayudarlo. Okay, en vez de estar hablando de él. So instead es lo como en vez de. Okay, that is instead. You got
okay.
It? Yeah, así like the same phrase. La palabra instead es en vez de o en lugar de. That is the translation. Okay? Entonces esta parte diría, nada, estoy de acuerdo. Deberíamos ayudarlo. Instead, ese instead es como en vez de estar hablando de él. You see? All right, any other vocabulary word?
Agree, estoy de acuerdo. Es.
Agree es like, estar de acuerdo.
Ah, okay.
Yes. So, si yo les digo, I agree with you, estoy de acuerdo con ustedes. You see, I agree with you. Very good. Any other word that you do not understand? ¿Alguna otra palabra, frase que no comprendamos o no estemos seguros de la pronunciación? Nope. Okay. What are we going to do with this conversation? All right. We're going to practice it. How are we going to practice this conversation? Ah, in here, one by one. How come? I want William help me out with this conversation and Carla. Let's practice it right now. William, I want you to be Raúl and Carla is going to be Claudia.
Okay, teacher. I can't believe it. Robert is addicted to his phone. Do you see him?
You are right. He should not chat in the meeting.
Absolutely. That is not polite.
He should answer his message after the meetings, and we should not talk about him. That's not polite.
Polite.
That's not polite either.
Okay, very good.
I agree. We shall help him stay.
Instead. Okay, very good. All right. Thank you, William, and thank you, Carla. Now I want Hilmar and Fatima to help me out.
Okay.
Fatima, Mark.
Okay. I can't believe it. Robert is addicted to his phone. Did you see him?
You're right. He should not chat in a meeting.
Absolutely. That is not polite.
He should answer his messages after the meetings, and we should not talk about him. That's not polite either.
I agree. We shall help him instead.
Instead, okay. Are you? Hey, Fatima, why do you do that face? ¿Por qué hizo esa expresión? Parecía el emoji ese de la carita en los emojis de WhatsApp. Like. That was funny. Okay, Eric, help me have a ring in this conversation with Nubia.
Okay, ¿con quién, teacher?
With Eric.
Ah, okay. ¿Quién comienza?
You.
Okay. I can't believe it. Robert is addicted to his phone. Did you see him?
You're right. He should not chat in a meeting.
Absolutely. That is not polite.
He should answer his messages after the meetings, and we should not talk about him. That's not polite either.
Agree. We should help him instead.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Nubia. Thank you, Eric. Now, Salvador and Roxana, let's do it. Roxana, start.
Salvador.
Para Rosana.
I can't believe it. Robert is addicted to his phone. Did you see him?
You're right. It's all not hang. He should not chat in a meeting.
Absolutely. That is not polite.
Very good.
He should answer his
messages
after the meeting. And he should not talk about him. That's not polite
either. Very good.
I agree. We should help him instead.
Nah, okay, very good. We should help him instead. All right. Thank you, Roxana. Thank you, Salvador. Now, Ever and Sara, help me out.
Okay. I can't believe it's Robert. It's addicted to his phone. His phone. Did you see him?
You're right. He should have shot in the meeting.
Absolutely. That is not polite.
He should answer his message after the meeting. And we should not talk about him. That's not polite either.
Agreed. We should hit him instead.
Okay, very good. Thank you, Ever and Sara. Now, Rosa, didn't you sleep? Okay, I think Rosa's sleeping. Okay, Ana Maria, help me out with Mrs. Urrutia.
Okay, ¿quién inicia? Yo.
Yes.
Okay. I cannot believe it. Robert is addicted to his phone. Do you see him?
You're right. He should not chat in a meeting.
Absolutely. That is no polite.
He should answer his message after the meeting, and we should not talk about him. That's not polite either.
Okay, very good.
I agree. We should help him instead.
Help him instead.
Okay. Help him then.
All right, very good. Hey, Ana Maria, that was horrible. Hey,
sí,
grosero.
No,
es que yo le vi.
Qué malo.
No,
I'm not talking
no
about
le
the,
caso,
the, I'm not talking
no
about
le
the
caso.
Conversation.
Está preciosa.
No.
Se ve mal, no se ve mal, se ve muy bien.
No, es que le acabo de enviar mis fotos del pie.
Pie
y está
o sea,
terrible.
Bueno.
De la lesión que tuvo, no, not the conversation. Ey, esa es Urrutia. Qué cizañosa, mire. Okay, no. Thank you, Ana María, and thank you, Stephanie. Okay, oh my God. Okay, Diana, I want you to help me out with Natalie. I think Natalie has not been better. Oh my God, you guys, your. Oh yeah.
Yo
empiezo.
Okay. Yeah. I can't believe it. Robert is addicted to his phone. Do you see him?
You're right. He should not chat in a meeting.
Absolutely. That is okay.
Absolutely. Repeat.
Absolutely.
Very good.
That is not police.
Polite.
Polite.
He should answer his messages after the meetings, and we should not talk about him. That's not polite either.
Agree. We should help him stay.
Instead. Now, okay, very good. Thank you, Diana. Thank you, Natalie. Hey, I had a deja vu right now. Okay, Jonathan, help me out with Ana Garcia. Still there, Ana? Oh, yeah, she's there.
Okay. I can't believe this girl is addicted to his phone. Did you see him?
You're right. You shouldn't. In a meeting.
Absolutely. That is not polite.
He should answer his messengers
after the meeting, and we should not talk about him. I'm not polite either.
Agreed, we should heal him instead.
Okay, we should help him instead. Thank you, Anna, and thank you, Jonathan. You did it.
Teacher.
Good. Yes.
Teacher. La otra semana, si en este lado tengo un morete, es parte de la caída que he tenido. Así que no me vayan a decir, le pegaron, que no sé qué. Porque aquí, es más, me sacaron radiografía de aquí. Porque aquí tengo el donde me pegué, que caí al suelo así.
My God, ¿really?
Sí.
Pero tiene un poquito inflamado, ¿verdad?
Radiografía porque pensaron que me había lastimado, o sea, la... Por eso está aquí, ve.
Ah, ok. Bien.
Así que probablemente esto se va a poner morado. Así
no,
que
listen. Vale, si se le ve hinchadito acá, se le ve gordito así, hay que hacer otra acá para que esté igual. Así.
¿Ve?
No, I'm kidding.
Qué malo.
I'm kidding you. No, espero que no se le ponga así, porque así a veces esos monetes duelen. Yeah. Yes. Especially for tomorrow. Ja. Mañana va a amanecer bien rico ese dolor.
Mire, Ani, hay una pomada, es una gel. Se llama Enantium, en gel. Usted se la aplica, pero no donde tiene raspones, sino que solo el golpe. Y eso no permite que se le quede muy morado. Buenísimo.
No, okay, very good. There you go. Okay, let's keep going with this. Listen up. This is part of what we were practicing, okay, before going into the manual. All right, we got in here, okay, the uses of should in positive and should not, okay, in negatives. All right, what do we have here? We have extra information. Some of the examples that we were practicing, that we were reading in the presentation, were taken from here, in negatives, okay? What are we gonna do with this information? We're gonna reread it again, and we're gonna complete this exercise, okay? This exercise. Okay. In here, what do we got? It says, the word should answer my good morning greeting. What does it say? El guardia debería contestar mi saludo, mi buen saludo de, you know, buenos días. No sé por qué es tan común. All right, that's part of the suggestion. In positive, okay? Mrs. Urrutia, read the second one, please. This one.
Linda showed great. With
greet,
fear,
greet,
greet. Mm-hmm. Okay, so greet with a
firm
handshake.
Okay. You know what is a handshake? For example, if I tell you, hey, si yo la veo en persona, Mrs. Ruggi, le digo, hey, nice to meet you, and I grab your hand and I do this with your hand like this. Handshake.
Ah, apretón fuerte.
Exactly, right? That's a handshake. Mm. Yes.
Okay.
Very good. Sara, read the next one, please.
The supervisor
should use greeting in his mail.
In his emails. Thank you. Yeah, the supervisor should use a greeting in his emails. El supervisor debería usar un saludo en sus emails, en sus correos. There you go. And we got in here another one. All right, William, let's read it.
You should say, please, when you ask for a favor.
A favor.
A favor.
Nah, okay, very good. You should say, please, when you ask for a favor. There you go. So that is a suggestion. ¿Qué estamos haciendo ahí? Dar una sugerencia, ¿ok? O en cierto grado, consejo, por así decirlo, ¿ok? So this is a positive. Y tenemos acá, dice, use should plus, ayúdenme a formar acá, plus infinity form o base form. ¿Cuál de los dos es?
Base form.
Ah, ok, very good. Base form of the verb plus any complement, ok, o phrase to express a direct suggestion. ¿Qué expresamos ahí? Acá tenemos la clave, a direct suggestion, una sugerencia directa, ok, hacia esa persona, ok, para que haga algo, right, that probably is beneficial for her or for him. Ok, now the negative ones. El ahora las formas negativas. ¿Cuándo las usamos? Ok, estos ejemplos ya los estuvimos leyendo en la presentación. Son los mismos de la presentación. Ok, tenemos acá. Use, should not. Listen up. Use, should not. Plus. The infinitive form or base form. Ah, we know. The base form, right? The base form of the verb plus any complement phrase to give a, listen up, a suggestion about something that is not appropriate. Ah, una sugerencia, ok, sobre algo que no es apropiado, ok, something that is not appropriate, ok, in that case we use should not. There you go. Entonces, es a modo de consejo o sugerencia para dar a alguien que no está haciendo algo de la manera correcta o apropiada, por decirlo así. ¿Ok? That will be the examples. All right. Hasta acá, people. ¿Tenemos alguna pregunta? Any question related to this topic? No? Nah? Okay. I like that. Okay, listen up. What are we going to do with this information? Listen, in here, we got some information. In this part, en esta parte, tenemos una información, tenemos cierta información. Listen. Esta información, acá, es algo que se debe o no se debe hacer, okay? ¿Qué es lo que quiero que hagan ustedes en esta parte? Ok, en estas líneas. Quiero que ustedes escriban, listen up, suggestions about the, okay, about the topic that is being talked. Van a leer cada una de las oraciones que tienen ahí y en cada caso van a dar una sugerencia, ya sea en positivo o negativo, sobre lo que ahí se dice. Example of it. Tenemos la número uno, dice, Peter is the new supervisor. He likes to give orders. Ah, Peter es el nuevo supervisor. A él le gusta dar órdenes. He never says please. Y nunca dice, por favor. Ah, ¿cuál es una de las sugerencias para esta persona? Y es así. Ah, tenemos opciones. Mire. Peter should ask polite requests. Ah, Peter debería pedir o solicitar algo de una manera educada, cortés. Peter should say please when asked for something. Ah, Peter debería decir por favor cuando pide algo. You see? Entonces, ahí, ¿qué estamos dando? Estamos dando sugerencias, ¿cierto? About something. Ahora bien, ¿qué vamos a hacer en estas? Vamos a hacer exactamente lo mismo como tenemos ese ejemplo. Example. All right, just a modest example. When Carl is angry or something are not as he expects, he shouts. Cuando Carlos está enojado o las cosas no son como, como él las espera, él grita. Ah, ¿cuál sería el consejo o la sugerencia que ustedes le darían? ¿Ok? ¿Qué vamos a hacer? Listen up. Ahorita no me las escriban. Esta parte, así, a modo de fotografía, la voy a subir en la sección de discusión de la plataforma. Y quiero que en los comentarios, ustedes ahí, me les escriban las sugerencias por cada una de ellas. ¿Ok? Let's put it there. Entonces, esa va a ser parte de la tarea para mañana. ¿Ok? Yo la voy a subir a modo de captura. ¿Ok? Y ahí ustedes abajo me les escriben a cada una la sugerencia. Leen la información y les escriben las sugerencias. ¿Ok? En la sección de comentarios. ¿Estamos? Ok, perfect. ¿Alguna pregunta? ¿Any question?
Para mañana, dijo.
¿Ah? Esta es, parte de la, esta es parte de la tarea y la podemos hacer mañana, of course.
Ah.
No, no la voy a hacer el lunes. Ok, because, you know, tenemos que ir ya en orden.
El domingo la puedo hacer. ¿Ah? Mañana es sábado.
Ok, I'm gonna be checking. Sí, este, ya voy a revisar a ver si, si ya me completaron el lunes la tarea. Ok, no, in that case. Entonces, lo podemos hacer, solo que sí les sugiero que, pues, si no las hacemos ahora, por lo menos el fin de semana, podemos completarlas, ¿ok? Uh-huh. Entonces, sí. Aparecerá en la sección discusión de la plataforma, ¿ok? You got the whole weekend to do it. All right. ¿Alguna pregunta con relación al tema? Any question related to the topic? No? Ok, good. Bien, voy a pasar a asistencia entonces y eso sería todo por esta sesión. And Nubia, se me va a quedar ahora, ¿ok? Today is your 10 minutes feedback. Give me a second, I'm gonna share this thing. Okay, Ana Claribel.
Present.
Okay, good. Ana María.
Present.
Nice. Y Ana Gabriela.
Present.
Okay, Eric Guillermo.
Present, teacher.
Very good. Ever de Jesús.
Present, teacher.
Nice. Fátima Alejandra.
Present, teacher.
Very good. Floridalia is not here. Hilmar Cruz.
Present.
Okay. Jonathan Alexander.
Present.
Very good. Carla Benazir.
Present, teacher.
Very good. Natalie Vanessa.
Present.
Very nice. Nubia Zulema.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Romeo Alexis.
Present.
All right. Rosa del Carmen.
Present.
Ah, where is Rosa? Ah, she's still not sleeping. Okay. Roxana Yesenia.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Salvador Alfonso.
Present, teacher.
Okay, very good. Sara Carolina.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Stephanie Lisette.
Present.
Señorita Cizañoso. Okay, William Alberto.
Present.
Okay, thank you. Joanny Noemi. Ah, Joanny's not here. And Stephanie Janet. And here is Stephanie, didn't show up. Okay, people. So that's going to be everything for this video conference. Fue un gusto estar con ustedes en esta videoconferencia. Que tengan un feliz fin de semana. Para los que trabajan, lo siento, yo también trabajo, así que estamos en las mismas. And see you on Monday, okay? Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye, good night.
Bye, good night.
Adios, everybody. Teacher.
Bye. Bye, Natalie.
Bye, teacher.
Bye, teacher. Bye.
Que se mejore, Ana María.
Gracias.
Le agradezco a Stephanie.
No, teacher.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye, bye.
Pórtese bien.
Usted también este fin de semana. All right. Bye, miss. Okay, Nubia. We're going to have the 10 minutes feedback. Okay. Just to clarify, any doubt, any question that you might have from this class and the previous classes, okay? So I'm all ears. Tell me, do you have any question? You got the microphone off. Todavía el micrófono apagado.
Ay, no, tío. Mire, yo no sé por qué esta computadora tengo que hasta darle duro para que me accione.
Sí, a veces suele pasar.
No, pero sí he logrado captar la idea de los temas y todo. Uh-huh. Pero sí creo que con la práctica uno como que se activa más.
Yes.
Se agarra más la idea.
Yes, that's the idea. How with the practice, that's like we can improve. Uh-huh. Yeah, those aspects. So I don't know if you have like very specific questions for very specific topics.
Ahorita estaba con esto del you, pero estaba viendo que cuando son negativas, en automático después de la palabra se le pone la palabra no.
Yes, después de you, es porque, vaya, recordemos que todo verbo auxiliar es como el cuando usamos el do. Después del do, automáticamente va la palabra not. Ok, ya fusionado sería don't. Entonces, algo similar es como actúa should. ¿Por qué? Porque should es básicamente un verbo auxiliar. Ok, sirve nada más para ser un auxiliar. Y cuando lo ponemos dentro de una oración, nos indica que estamos dando una sugerencia sobre algo. Ok, that's the function of should.
Y otra cosa es que aquí no se modifica ninguno de los verbos, se mantiene tal cual.
Exactly, es como los verbos.
Positivo como negativo.
Exactly, es como los verbos que estuvimos, las estructuras que estuvimos practicando ayer, son otras que son considerados verbos modales. Esos son verbos especiales porque no se modifican en tercera persona. So, podemos decir she could y no le vamos a agregar S al verbo. Así es should. Entonces, no se modifican con las terceras personas. Eso es un tanto beneficioso porque no tendríamos ese problema como de estar, you know, like, va con S, lleva ES, or something like that. It's like should, like, and that's it.
Pero en would, sí, se modifica el verbo.
Yes. Sí, porque do ya no es un verbo modal. Por eso. Y estos entran en la categoría de verbos modales. Esos son verbos especiales que de cierta manera nos indican cierto grado de obligación para dar consejos, sugerencias, para denotar habilidades, ¿ok? Things like that. Entonces, do no entra en esa categoría.
Pero, dice verdad que al ocupar el would y modificar el verbo con el ing, la respuesta al contestar sí se contesta ya en tercera persona.
¿Cómo así?
Por ejemplo, si se hago una pregunta usando el would y el verbo con el ing. Por ejemplo, el would you mind close, pero donde haya alguien con tercera persona. A la hora de contestar, ¿se contesta en tercera persona siempre? ¿O así, normal, el verbo?
¿En esa estructura, dice usted?
Ajá.
¿Así? ¿Would she mind closing the door?
No lo veo esto. Ok,
lo voy a cambiar de
color. Ajá, sí.
¿Like this?
Sí.
¿Would she mind closing the door?
Ah, ok, es que sí.
Yes. Entonces, es correcto crear este tipo de preguntas, solo que en este caso a la persona que se le pregunta es la persona que va a responder por la otra persona. Exacto. Entonces, por eso es que no practicamos esta estructura con terceras personas, ¿ok? Digamos que por ese mismo caso, porque hay otra que en representación de esa tercera persona tiene que responder, ¿ok? Por eso, no, la estructura es correcta, ¿ok? La estructura de la pregunta, like everything is correct, solo que hay ese detalle, ¿ok? Que en este caso Por eso es que es más usada en primera persona, nada más. Right? Yes.
Así, eso tenía yo ayer, pero ya me acordé que las respuestas son parecidas a las cuando se usa tú. Son respuestas cortas.
Exacto.
Se hace referencia de si es ella o él, sino que ahí queda.
Exactly. It remains like that. Exactly. Ajá, y recordemos que cuando usamos este tipo de estructura, ok, no podemos contestar. Vaya, por ejemplo, si yo pongo en esta oración acá, could you open the door, please? Yo no puedo contestar con yes, I could, que es como generalmente se contesta en las otras estructuras. Yo no puedo contestar así. La respuesta es correcta, porque sí, gramaticalmente hablando es correcta. Pero si yo le digo, yes, I could, ahí no le estoy garantizando que lo voy a hacer. Que voy a acatar a su solicitud en este caso. Ah, ¿podrías abrir la puerta, por favor? Sí, podría. Ah, si alguien le contesta, sí podría. O sea, significa que sí lo puedo hacer, pero no lo voy a hacer.
Ajá.
Okay. Entonces, por eso es que se utiliza más que todo. Ok. Yes, of course. Ajá. Right away, que es like ahorita mismo. Ok. In a moment. Ok. Right now. Ok. Entonces, por eso es que se contesta con ese tipo de expresiones así.
Mira, pero ahí hay otras respuestas que no habíamos visto ayer. Le voy a tomar una captura.
Which one?
Por ejemplo, right now, no la habíamos
right now,
visto.
Ah, really? Right now es lo mismo que right away, ahorita mismo. Son sinónimas.
Mm-hmm. Por ejemplo, in a moment, porque habíamos estado ocupando in a minute.
In a minute, ah. In a moment es like en un momento.
Sí.
Ya, yeah, so, entonces parte de ello y lo hacemos de esa manera, ¿ok? Este tipo de respuestas son las respuestas que damos a este tipo de preguntas. That's the way how we can use them. Why? Por lo mismo que le acabo de mencionar, que si lo respondemos así como respondemos las otras estructuras, entonces como que no estaríamos dando una respuesta meramente positiva.
Queda como abierta la posibilidad como...
Es como que sí puedo, pero no lo voy a hacer. You know? Entonces es como que queda en el limbo ahí de que si lo hace o no.
Ajá, tiene razón.
Exactly. Yes. All right. Besides that, I don't know if you have any other question, Nubia.
No, teacher, solo eso que estaba ayer con eso de, pero ahorita me queda ya más claro que no hay problema a la hora de poner una respuesta, porque en las dos opciones las respuestas son respuestas bien cortas y generales, por decirlo así.
Exactly, in general. Yeah. Okay, very good. So, entonces, esa era más que todo la duda que tenía entonces.
Es.
Okay, good. Con la plataforma, ¿cómo vamos? Like, are we okay?
Bien, ahora hice las tareas de toda la semana hasta la, quiero ver, la 15 o la 16.
Nah, ok, entonces.
Pero de la 17 para allá ya no me dio opción, me imagino yo que como.
It's because we don't have that
open. Cada semana me imagino yo que la vi.
Exactly, that's the way how they go.
Entonces, solo me quedaría, por ejemplo, entiendo que me puedo volver a meter a la plataforma de lo que yo ya hice en las tareas.
Yes,
y adicionar esto, y adicionar la tarea del día de ahora.
Yes, you can do it. Okay. Yeah, you can do it. Ajá, y sí, y voy a entrar y quedaría abierta para la sección de discusión para lo que voy a subir, ¿ok? Ajá. The picture about that.
Y sería ahí para comentar. Lo único que me quedaría pendiente de ahora.
Okay, perfect.
En esta semana.
Yes, this week. Uh-huh. Okay, yeah. Nubia. There you go, entonces. Estamos bien, entonces. Okay, Nubia, entonces, espero que tenga un buen fin de semana y nos vemos el próximo lunes, okay?
Yes. clases igualmente usted right. con su okay. esposa y el baby.
Ah, thank you.
Hola, baby.
Now,
Nina, anyway, perdón.
El baby.
El baby.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you, Nuria. Okay, Nuria.
Feliz noche, que Dios me lo bendiga.
Gracias, igualmente.
Okay. Bye bye. Adiós.